Yeah, it's 6 in the morning and there's quite a line waiting to get into the park. Yeah, 6:40, fairly long line coming in. Yeah, it's 7:10, we're signing in at the A-Ball Slide Trail. The A-Ball Trail begins just to the left of Lane 2, number 11. It's a sign, but it's back from the road. Sometimes it's blocked by people at the campsite. Yeah, it's about 8 o'clock, and we're at the start of the A-Ball Trail. It's supposed to be a solar eclipse today at about 2 o'clock. The original A-Ball Trail is pretty smooth and easy hiking. Here's the first view of Katahdin, and there's a cutoff here for a spring partway up the A-Ball Trail. The original A-Ball Trail followed a rock slide up the mountain. It became unstable, and the trail's been moved to the left. A little longer, but less steep. Gone 2.53 miles, and we've rejoined the old A-Ball Slide Trail. You can see the old trail right the new cutoff on the side. It's the old trail which we're rejoining and going to the top. Thoreau Spring joining the hunt trail for the last mile up to Katahdin. Here's the spring. It's fairly dry today. The GPS says we've gone 2.98 miles to this point. That's a view of the summit. Going over to Pomola. It's 10:45 and I'm GPS is reading 4.01 miles to the top by the A-Ball Trail. Very nice hike. It's Chimney Pond. Knife Edge. And the summit. Maybe the toughest part of the A-Ball Trail. Some of the new A-Ball Trail, very nice. Really tight fit up ahead here. Nice stonework on the new A-Ball Trail. Back at the ranger station at about 2 o'clock, the GPS says 8.26 miles. There's supposedly a partial eclipse right now, but things are still pretty bright. So it's 2 o'clock and we've got a partial eclipse going on. they're able to see it with eclipse glasses.
Push the button. Oh, yeah. It's on. You're
full. Oh, I'm doing good. I'm recording now. Okay.
That took it. All right.